here we go. So the flour butter mixture has been sitting for about 5 minutes. And now I need to add in my eggs one at a time. So plop one egg in there and rapidly beat it in. See how it's all separate like that? You need to make sure it's incorporated it in thoroughly before you add the other egg. So you have to, you have to make sure that you go really, really fast. It's a good workout. Gotta get this stuff in there. Just like this. Okay, so that's good. And then add another egg. You have to kind of go slow in the beginning or else all the stuff is going to pop out of the pot. And then you build up speed. Your arm might get tired. Like mine is right now. Ah. You have some strength over there? Gosh, I'm serious. You want to come and help me? I need help. All right. Ow, I have a bad arm. All right, and then so one more egg. So I have my assistant here. Thanks, Alexandra.
You're welcome.
Okay. And once she gets that incorporated in, we're going to add another one. It looks real good. I'm going to get a zoom in here on the mixture itself. Yeah, just like that. So that looks good. And then we're going to add another egg. Your arm getting tired? You have strong arms, though.
Oh, thank you. I remember doing this this year.
And that is getting good. Yeah, if you can switch arms, that's a good thing. All right, a few tips before we start piping out the pâte à choux. One is we're going to show you how to assemble and fill the pastry bag. Of course, you have to cut open the pastry bag. You're going to make a huge cup. And if you have a buddy, you can have the buddy hold it. I'm going to show you how to hold the pastry bag and make sure that your dominant hand is on top to squeeze it out and the bottom hand moves the bag around. Then we're going to show you how to position the bag straight, not at an angle, and at least 1 inch above the parchment paper. And of course, how to disassemble the bag. All right, so the pastry bag. We have our pastry bag, our disposable pastry bag. And the first thing I did was cut off the tip to make an opening wide enough to put the star pastry bag tip or star piping tip into the pastry bag. I want to make a huge cup, as big as possible, like bigger than your hand. Then I need to make sure I have my rubber spatula, scrape all the pâte à choux off of it. And if you had a buddy, the buddy could hold it. If not, then you can put your whole hand inside the cup and it is just fine. And you know you made a good pâte à choux if it's nice and thick like this. Look, nothing's fallen off. Nice and thick. And get it all the way closest to the tip as possible. Put the bag down so I can get in here. This is super good pâte à choux. Just like this. load the bag up, all of it. You want all of it in order to make your 6 heart-shaped cream puffs. Okay, and there you go. I'm gonna close the bag up. Look, I have it nice all towards the end of the tip there. Squeeze it up. Now my dominant hand, I write with my right hand, so that's the dominant hand on top. The other hand, it just slightly pushes it here, it steers the bag. I want to hold the bag straight up, not at an angle, just straight up. And hold the tip, make sure you have at least 1 inch away from the paper. And make sure your paper is turned upside down where the Sharpie is touching the pan. And we want to pipe inside the lines. Again, holding straight up. And move very, very slow and let the gravity do its thing. If you pipe outside the lines, you're not going to have enough batter for all 6. Just like that. Now release the pressure and let go. Here we go, do it again. Again, holding the bag straight up and 1 inch above the paper, release pressure, let go. There's a little hole here, I might want to fill the hole. There's a hole here. Pat it down. You can wet your finger and just pat it down. And here we go again. Again, inside the lines. I'm going to show you what you shouldn't do. You should not touch the tip onto the paper. See, if you're like this, it's not going to be very high. We want it to be thick. And the only way to get it thick is raise it up off the paper at least 1 inch, if not more. And I'm down to 2 more hearts here. Meanwhile, I have the oven preheating at 425. And we're going to bake these for approximately, 30 to 40 minutes. Now I can use the extra here to make it higher and fill in little holes that I have. If I want to make a profiterole, it's just a round little circle. Like that. That would be a profiterole. Now to clean this, the tip, I just need to cut it off the bag, throw away this disposable bag, and pop this puppy out and clean it. Now I'm going to put it in the oven and bake it for 30 to 40 minutes.